To switch into my British accent, my American was so weird, but I mean, comes naturally.
One of the reasons that Stranger Things is such a beloved show is because the cast of it are just so good together. From the adults to the teens to the kids, they're really good together. In fact, they're so good that they won a SAG Award for Best Ensemble Cast, and that's saying something. So together, they're great, but how about separately? Well, they're just as good, and you might have seen them in other roles besides their time in Hawkins, Indiana. So allow us to show you 9 other shows you didn't know the Stranger Things cast members were in. Be sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel.
Do you want to win any of these items on your screen? If so, be sure to watch the whole video, leave a like, and comment the hidden message. And with that being said, let's get right into the video.
9. Winona Ryder, Heathers. When it comes to Winona Ryder, she's easily the biggest name on the show before it exploded. And many people would put her over her co-stars in terms of lovability and just how she plays her character. And as one of the elder statesmen, if you will, she's been around and done a lot. She's been an 80s icon, a notorious necklace-stabbing gangster, and a tattoo on Johnny Depp's arm. She's grabbed her fair share of the silver screen with A Girl Interrupted, Beetlejuice, Reality Bites, Mermaids, Bram Stoker's Dracula, and Edward Scissorhands. Unlike a lot of youthful stars, Ryder aged gracefully, playing characters in her own age in Star Trek and Black Swan, and she did a few stints in gleefully trashy B-movies like The Iceman and Homefront. If we're gonna pick a role, though, that is definitely not one from your radar, that would have to be Winona Ryder as Veronica in Heathers, a very over-the-top film that had many, memorable quotes. BT Dubs. Fun fact, Winona's hair in Stranger Things is modeled after Meryl Streep's in Silkwood, which came out in the year in which the show takes place. The Duffer Brothers love 80s references, so why not make an actual 80s icon look like another? Winona is beloved by many, and they can see her time in Stranger Things as a career resurgence of sorts, and honestly, she deserves it. 8. David Harbour, Hellboy and Black Widow. Sticking with the adults for now, let's talk about the other megastar of the adults in David Harbour, who plays Chief Hopper. Harbour has some minor and major roles throughout his career. He's appeared in Black Mass, Banshee, Manhattan, The Newsroom, Quantum of Solace, End of Watch, Revolutionary Road, Brokeback Mountain, and played Dr. Kinsey in Kinsey. He had a standout role in The Equalizer as the corrupt cop to Denzel Washington's vigilante. But arguably his biggest roles were ones that have come out recently or are waiting to arrive. He was Hellboy in the reboot that came out last year and bombed horribly. But hey, A for effort. A more likely success is that he's gonna be Red Guardians in the upcoming Black Widow movie, and the few scenes of him we viewed in the trailers shows he's gonna be in top acting form. Of course, it's rather hilarious he's playing a Russian in Black Widow, considering Russians are one of the main enemies in Stranger Things, and of course, the Russians are currently imprisoning Chief Hopper in Season 4. The irony. 7. Finn Wolfhard, CW Shows and It. Finn Wolfhard is one of the main kids in Stranger Things who most definitely has had a good career since his time on the show. But he's also been one who's been around Hollywood as a whole, including appearing in some really interesting shows in a variety of interesting characters. For you fans of the CW, he was on both Supernatural and The 100. In Supernatural, he played Jordy Pinsky, a kid whose parents were killed and it was revealed that a person close to him was doing it to save him. In The 100, he played Zoran, who was a character with a huge facial deformity, which obviously couldn't have been the easiest role to play, and yet he did it. Of course, after Stranger Things came to be, Finn got one of the biggest roles of his career by being in the Stephen King reboot of It as Richie Tozier. The film was not only a record-breaking success, but Finn and the rest of the Losers Club were praised for their portrayal of the iconic characters, including winning awards for being the best on-screen team. 6. Joe Keery, Empire. Joe Keery might be the internet's favorite babysitter today, but back in 2015, he was Tony Trichter III in Empire. Appearing in the episode Who I Am, Keery portrayed the grandson of a wealthy businessman. He also got his own rapping scene. Carey also appeared in episodes of Sirens and Chicago Fire that same year. While he doesn't have any more upcoming TV appearances on the roster, he will be featured in the forthcoming sci-fi action comedy Free Guy alongside Ryan Reynolds. Plus, it's only a matter of time before he gets even more roles. He honestly is that good and has had a range to his acting abilities, as his appearances prove. Who wouldn't want to hire him? 5. Millie Brown, Godzilla, King of the Monsters. Godzilla is an icon in the world today, whether you realize it or not. He was born in Japan, but soon crossed over into the United States and beyond via various media, including an animated series, We Kid You Not. And over the many, many decades of his existence, he's had many movies, including one so bad that it was bought out by the original creators in Japan, rebranded as Zilla, and then put into a real Godzilla movie just so the true king of the monsters could kill it. It happened. Look it up. Anyway, the reason we're bringing this up is because in 2014, a new American Godzilla movie was released and it was really good. So a sequel was made via Godzilla King of the Monsters, and guess what? It featured Millie Brown as one of the main characters via Madison Russell. Madison had a special connection with Godzilla himself, because of course she did, and as a result, she played a major part in certain plot points. Now, ironically, the first Godzilla movie was praised and criticized for its sparse use of Godzilla and focus instead on the human characters. When King of the Monsters came out, the movie was criticized for its lack of focus on the human characters and having too much Godzilla and other monsters. Which is crap in our minds, obviously, and people really need to learn to make up their minds. But of course, this doesn't mean that this was Millie's fault. Far from it. It just means people are fickle and need to get their act together. 4. Caleb McLaughlin, Shades of Blue. While we may not appreciate that Caleb McLaughlin's character in Stranger Things preferred new Coke to regular Coke, you're insane! We can appreciate that Caleb is quite an actor and has been on many series before his time on Stranger Things. In addition to making cameos in Law & Order, Unforgettable, and Forever, he acted in 3 episodes of NBC's Jennifer Lopez-run thriller, Shades of Blue. It was in season 1 where he had a recurring role as JJ. What makes this even more standout-ish, if you will, is that he was filming this show and Stranger Things at the same time, so he was a very busy kid. Ironically enough, while Stranger Things is about to get a 4th season, Shades of Blue ended at 3 and Caleb didn't reprise his role again. Oh, here's another fun fact. Caleb was one of many young actors to play young Simba in the Broadway version of The Lion King. 3. Karen Buono, Mad Men. Far before she played Mike and Nancy's mom, Karen Wheeler, Karen Buono was taking up roles in a whole slew of movies. On the big screen, it was Gladiator, Hulk, and Paper Towns. On the small screen, it was Law & Order, The Sopranos, and Mad Men. Which, if you look at those names, you realize that was in some big pictures and series. Yes, even Hulk. Buono appeared in 10 episodes of Mad Men, ultimately getting nominated for a Primetime Emmy Award for Outstanding Guest Actress in a Drama Series. Which is saying something when you think about it. She portrayed Dr. Faye Miller, a psychologist and consultant who does market research for Sterling Cooper Draper Price. It's clear that Buono is very skilled at playing roles of all varieties. And now she's big on Stranger Things, yet another major hit show to add to her already incredible resume. No, seriously, people would kill for being in this many shows and films with that much praise and recognition. 2. Gaten Matarazzo, Les Miserables and Blacklist. Gaten Matarazzo is already a Broadway vet, which isn't something you'd expect from someone his age, yet is entirely true. He performed in Les Mis, which is one of the most famous musicals and shows ever. This, in many ways, was what got him into acting as a whole, because he used his Broadway experience to prepare him for what came in Hollywood. His only credit besides Stranger Things, though, is The Blacklist, the hit NBC spy show. So at age 13, he's already been on 2 TV mega hits, which again is something that most people would kill to have, even though Gaten was only in a small role for 1 episode. 1. Noah Schnapp, The Peanuts Movie. Noah Schnapp plays Will Byers on Stranger Things, and in many ways, he's a linchpin on the show, despite small screen time in the series. But if you don't recognize his face, you might recognize his voice, mainly because he's an accomplished voice actor. He was not only in The Book of Pooh, but he was in the Peanuts movie as none other than Charlie Brown. He even voiced a Peanuts video game. Pretty cool, huh? So, what did you think? What did you think of this look at the Stranger Things cast and the roles that they've played outside of the show? Do you remember seeing them in some of these other shows, or do you remember them from something else? Let us know down in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time on the channel.
A simple reminder on how to enter our brand new giveaway. We will be giving away either an iPhone X Max, the new iPad mini, or a MacBook Pro. It's really your choice. So be sure to leave a like, comment the keyword, subscribe, and turn on notifications to enter the giveaway. It's really that simple. Go for it.